Well, I guess that's on. Hello, everyone, and welcome. Welcome to those of you here in Denison, and welcome to those of you who are on live stream with us. Wonderful to see all of you. My name is Joan Bezek-Stilquist, and I'm the president of the Missoula Community Chorus Board of Directors. And it's so great to see everyone here, and it's so wonderful to have both Empower Voices with us and our children's choir. It's going to be an amazing performance. I really wanted to thank all of the sponsors who have helped us out. You can see their names in the program, and one way of giving back to them is visiting their businesses and keep moving forward. Our season sponsors are the Good Food Store and Calva Law Firm, and our concert sponsor is Allegiance. We're also very excited to announce that we have received a Dennis and Phyllis Washington Foundation grant. And this is to support those new additions to our chorus family, Empower Voices, and our children's choir. And I also just want to thank our community, which also, of course, is all of our singers, our conductors, our board members, and all of you. And I want you all to know that you're very welcome to come sing with us. There's information in the program about that. Join us. Join us on stage. Join us in the hall. It's all wonderful. Finally, I'd like to say that we acknowledge not only the land on which we make music today, but also the history and the people. This is the traditional land of Salish, Kootenai, and Ponderay. It is also crucial to mention the importance of this land to other surrounding tribes that have used this territory in the past, including the Blackfeet. We acknowledge our privilege to be making music on this land today. Thank you so much.
It's great to be here.
Let us all sing Christ's pleasures and count his name. Thank you very much. Thanks for that warm welcome. I take it there's some Monty Python fans out there. When life seems jolly rotten, there's something you've forgotten, and that's to laugh and smile and dance and sing. Well, this group does that extremely well, if I may say so. So we are Empower Voices. My name is Malcolm Lowe. The assistant conductor was Heidi Schnarr. I appreciate your patience as we move choirs back and forth here. It's what's really cool about this evening is it's the first time all of MCC's choruses have been together on the same concert. So it's just a delight for us to actually be on the big stage with everybody else. So thank you, MCC. So my first job when I first got out of college was at the Oregon Shakespeare Festival, and there was sort of an apocryphal fable about the famous soliloquy, to be or not to be. And it was said that that was written just to cover a scene change. So I'm gonna go with that tonight, but it may be setting you up for a disappointment. So a little bit about Empower Voices. Elaine Dolson came to me in 1998 and said, I have this idea, wouldn't it be great if when young people, you know, with disabilities get out of high school, there's this sort of social vacuum, there's nothing, and often they're just sort of end up being left at home. And so she said, let's do something where they can engage in the way that all of us that are involved in this choir know. It's a social outlet, it's an artistic outlet, it's fun. So we began a choir with 8 voices back then in 1998. At that time, we were called VSA Arts Choir. VSA being a program that came from the Kennedy Center. Gene Kennedy Smith started the program and there was a chapter in every state, although it was stationed in the Kennedy Center. Montana had a chapter. That chapter in the mid 2000s, 2015 or so, sort of disbanded and some of the funding went away, and so it was a challenge to keep that program going. So that's where our question was, does this choir to be or not to be? And Missoula Community Chorus stepped forward and said, we think it's important that this choir continues in this town, in this state. And so they took us under their wing. We renamed ourselves Empower Voices. And that's where we are today. So before I let you all sing, I'm going to be greedy and plug. Our focus is in 2 weeks. On May 22nd, we invite you all to come. We are doing a production of Alice in Wonderland at Missoula Community Theater. It's a Monday night, and it's the biggest thing we've ever tried. And you should come check it out, because it's going to be a blast. Or something. It's going to be something. So without further ado, here is Dr. Corrine Duffy.
Sometimes people, they don't treat me right. Don't they know the good Lord to keep me in your sight? Don't they know the good Lord will make everything all right? My good Lord, teach me how to pray. Teach me how to pray. Lord, good Lord.
Thank you. Check, check.
Some come here to fiddle and dance, some come here to tarry, some come here to fiddle and dance, but I come here to marry. Wish I was a banjo string made of golden twine. Every time I play on it, I wish that girl was mine.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Cinco de Mayo. Happy Cinco de Mayo. We are singing De Colores, and I had asked the kids in the choir if they would make some art that evokes spring. Some of it is abstract, some of it is not, and it was fabulous. And so the artwork that you see behind you while they are singing De Colores was done by these singers, so they can sing and make wonderful visual art as well. I just want to say how honored I am to be the founding conductor of Missoula Forte Choir. They fill my bucket every week with their energy, with their beautiful singing, with their humor, and just the sparkle that they have in their voices. I didn't have to teach them that energy When we do the movement, they just took right to it. I didn't have to teach that at all. And I would be remiss if I didn't give credit where credit is due. I get to be the face of this choir, but it is indeed a village. And Lexi Vine and Hector Pitstick, who are our accompanist and assistant director, have been wonderful to work with. Thank you very much. There's also some behind the scenes help that happens, and to the board and the people that have helped put this all together, thank you very much. It's a village effort. And thank you to the parents for making sure your kids got to rehearsals and helping with chaperoning, It's just been a wonderful experience, and thank you very much. So we want to leave you with, and you guys know the answer to this joke because we told it before. Okay, so we're going to tell you a joke. I'm trying to kill time so that we can all get up here. But what is Beethoven's favorite fruit? Ready? Okay, thank you very much.
Test. Oh, we got it. We got it. Okay. So you'll read all about this in your program, but I'm just going to tell all the children so you know. The next two songs that we're going to sing were both written not 100 years ago, not 200 years ago, not 300 years ago, 400 years ago. Yes, this first one was published in 1623. And this year is 2023. That's right. And they're both unique pieces from the time period because they come from unlikely composers. The first one was a Jewish composer living in the ghetto in Mantua, Italy. So you'll get to hear this incredible piece. He wrote a whole compendium for the synagogue, the first of its kind ever, called the Songs of Solomon. The second piece you'll hear comes from Mexico, where the composer, Gaspar Fernandez, who was working in Guatemala, got a job in Mexico, in Puebla, in right around 1600, 1610, and he started writing down some of the music that he heard from the Nahua people who were living there. And so the first piece is in Hebrew, the second piece is in a mixture of Spanish and Nahuatl. So I think, I'm not sure, because it's hard to prove a negative, but I think this is the Montana premiere of both of these pieces. It only took 400 years, and we're going to hope that we'll hear it again. We don't have to wait 400 and more years for the next time, but I hope you enjoy these next two pieces.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Check, check. Thank you all so very much for coming tonight. This whole show has been such fun to put on, as you can tell. We have so many wonderful singers in our midst, and we're happy to have all of our choirs represented tonight. I'd like to thank Tork Torgerson, manager of the Denison Theater, for everything that he did, he and his team, to make the concert possible. Dr. Brian Costers is running the live stream. We're grateful to him as well. He's also our composition faculty member here at the University of Montana. We're so grateful to both of them. The president of the Missoula Community Chorus, Joan Steelquist, the executive director, Robin Rose, all of the artistic directors of the ensembles, including Malcolm Lowe, Renee Gibson, our accompanists, Mac Merchant, Hector Pitstick, our assistant directors, Heidi Schnarr, Lexi Vine. We're so grateful to all of you, the members of our board. Thank you so much. We're grateful also to our sponsors and our donors. We hope you will consider giving to our organization, whether you already had a chance in Missoula Gives or in the future. We so appreciate, and you can see what we can do for our community and how we bring folks together. Speaking of bringing people together, this last number features all of our children and everyone in MCC. We're going to sing Shalom Chaverim, which means Shalom friends, farewell, we'll see you again soon. Lehitraot, come again, go in peace. Thank you.